Hello everybody, Ninetales Commander here, and welcome to episode 8 of Super Smash Bros. So, topic for today, Miiverse! Yes, Miiverse, that wonderful service that everybody is going to miss. Now, I say that, and yes, I was being sarcastic, but actually, when I actually said that originally to myself, I was actually surprised when I found out how inaccurate that actually was, because to my actual surprise, there are people that are actually not happy with Miiverse being shut down. And I'm not going to say they're wrong, because, well, it's all opinions and I respect that, but I gotta say, I was legitimately surprised to find that people are actually bothered at the dismissal of Miiverse, because I honestly thought it was going to be a service that people were not going to care about. Like, it was going to be a service that Nintendo shuts down, and people were going to be like, whatever, I didn't really like it anyway, so I don't really care. But no, apparently I was wrong on that, and to my surprise, people are actually bummed out by this. So I decided, since it's quite a controversial topic, I thought, well, let's weigh in my thoughts on this then. So here we go. Okay, so exactly what are the downsides that are going to be brought with the Miiverse service from basically being shut down? Well, there is a number of downsides, and they tend to vary from game to game. But the universal one that people seem to be sad about is the fact that you're no longer going to be able to see Miiverse posts in the actual gameplay. See, if you play games like Super Smash Bros. On the Miiverse stage, or Super Mario Maker, or you're in Inkopolis in Splatoon, you will see Miiverse posts show up that are relevant to the game that you are playing. Now, this is a feature I personally never really cared for. In fact, in most games that I play that have a Miiverse feature, I usually found myself turning them off because I actually found them to be a distraction more than anything. Now, to be fair, that is more relevant to me as a person and doesn't reflect the entire gaming community. It really isn't the type of thing that really everyone is gonna hate or everyone is gonna love. It's more just some people love it, some people hate it. For the people that love it, they leave it turned on. For some people that hate it, they simply switch it off. So, fair enough, in that area, I can understand people that do like the feature be bummed out about it vanishing. Like I said, I never really cared about it. I was under the impression that most people didn't care about it, but clearly I was wrong on that note, and yes, in that sense, I can understand people not being happy about that particular part of Miiverse disappearing. But if I may also offer my honest opinion, I also think it's going to be something that people, they'll be bummed out by at the beginning, but eventually give it a few weeks, maybe a month or something like that, or heck, maybe even a few days, and they'll quickly get used to it not being there. Obviously, I never played with it turned on to begin with, so I personally didn't care, but I do think it's something that people are going to quickly adjust to once they start playing the games without Miiverse. Assuming that you still play them, of course. You might not even play those games anymore because you may have just moved on to the Nintendo Switch. Even though games like Super Mario Maker are still played by people because that game is only on the Wii U and nobody cared about the 3DS version. As for Splatoon, well, the only people that I know that still play Splatoon 1 are simply people that don't have a Nintendo Switch yet, which is fair enough, I totally understand that, so again, fair enough. But I do think it's something people are going to get used to living without, but at the same time, I do understand why they may be bummed out about it not offering that service anymore. So as far as the Miiverse posts go, I can understand why people are bummed out about that, but the area that I really cannot understand why people are bummed out about are the Miiverse features that are relevant to specific games. Now, of course, I'm not going to go through every single game on the Wii U that has a Miiverse feature installed into it, but I'm going to focus on the major ones, and the first one I want to crack onto is Mario Kart 8. Now, I actually didn't know this until recently, probably because I never played on tournament mode, but apparently the tournament mode on Mario Kart 8 on the Wii U actually required you to have a Miiverse account. Now, I could be wrong on this, but I never heard it said before, but I think that may be the case, and if that's the case, people that played the tournament mode in the original Mario Kart 8, well, yeah, that does kind of suck. It means you cannot host your own tournaments anymore, and you basically, the tournament mode is gone. And the other area to Mario Kart 8 that is being terminated is the ability to upload your replays or your highlight reels over to YouTube. Now, the tournament mode, again, I can get behind because I know people that did like that feature, assuming I'm right in hearing that that feature is being terminated, though I don't quite see why it would need Miiverse, but who knows. But the Mario Kart 8 highlight reels, I thought, why do people care about that? Because to me, the upload reels for Mario Kart 8 was abysmal. Like, the quality of the video, of course, wasn't as good as using a capture card. And of course, the limitations placed on it were just unreasonable. The highlight reels for uploading to YouTube had to be 30 seconds. So you couldn't even upload the entire race. You had to limit it to a 30-second highlight reel. And of course, in the process, Nintendo Content ID claims the video, so of course then you can't even make money off of it. Although I suppose in that exception, I can understand Nintendo claiming the money because, well, you're not really doing anything on your part, you're more playing their game, and you're just uploading it without hardly any effort. But here's the problem, nobody, to my knowledge, cared about the highlight reel system because of the limitations that were placed upon it. So to me, why do people care about this? It's a silly feature that not many people like to begin with, and if you were a YouTube gamer, you most likely are going to have a capture card to be able to record the footage yourself. So why do you even need the YouTube uploader? It just feels like a really petty thing to complain about going missing when it's something that not many people cared about to begin with. I can get behind the tournament mode, I can totally get behind that, I can understand that if that's the case, but the upload replays, the highlight reels, no, I don't see why people care about that, because it was a pretty restrictive and bad feature to begin with, and if you really do care about it that much, then just go buy a capture card. Yeah, that's the way I see it anyway. I know you might not be able to afford one, and yeah, okay, in that case, fair enough. But most YouTube gamers I know do have one. Now, this next one is the one that I honestly have no clue how people find this to be a problem. And that is relevant to the game that's on screen right now, Smash Bros. 4. So this game had Miiverse compatibility. Well, it had a Miiverse feature installed into it. What was this feature? It was basically a Miiverse stage. You would fight on it, and in the background, you would get Miiverse posts that are relevant to the characters that are appearing on screen. Now, I'll be honest, when I first heard of this feature, I thought, okay, that's pretty cool. I like that. And it was even a free stage for anybody that owned the game. That's cool, I really liked that. But then I found out something that I really didn't like. The fact that the Miiverse stage is offline only. Now, am I the only person that finds that really ironic? Miiverse is supposed to be an online focused service. You log in on the internet into Miiverse and you post for the games that you are playing. It is basically an online service for people to be able to communicate with each other. And this stage could not be used online in the game itself. Am I the only person that found that to be quite ironic? I found that to be really ironic because Miiverse is an online service. That's ridiculous, in my honest opinion, and I don't understand why Nintendo made the decision to make the Miiverse stage only be offline. And before anybody comes at me saying, oh, but they didn't want people to see the horrible posts that may show up online, yeah, you can turn them off. Yeah, you can basically turn the Miiverse posts off if you really don't care for them. This is actually what... Actually, no, I would say I turned them off, but I actually didn't because I never played on that stage. The only time I did play on that stage was when I was practicing offline and the random select happened to have picked the Miiverse stage. That's literally my entire history with the Miiverse stage on Smash 4. So to me, this service that is ending on the Miiverse stage in this game, it's not even a big issue because you can't even play that stage online. And yeah, okay, it did have its uses offline, but the stage itself to me wasn't really that impressive. It was basically just a render of the Miiverse theme with a Smash Brothers styled platform, like the one you're seeing right now, which is the Halberd stage. But it was basically Final Destination Miiverse mode, or Miiverse themed. That's basically all it was. It was free, so I never really criticized it because, you know, it's fine. It was free, you know, nobody really complained about it. And, you know, I understand that, but to not include that stage on the online, I thought that was a bad decision. And if there ever is a Smash 4 port, that's one of the things I would like to see get fixed, because to me, it would have been nice. Actually, it can't be fixed because Miiverse isn't even on the Nintendo Switch. Now, this is what brings me to the next part of this video that I want to go over. What could be the replacement for Miiverse if there's going to be one? Well, here's my honest theory on what they're going to do with this. I believe that Miiverse as a service is going to come to a close. I believe that it's going to come to a close because of the fact that many games, or at least right now with Splatoon 2, are featuring a system that is similar to Miiverse. In Splatoon 2, there is a feature that is very reminiscent of Miiverse. You can basically share these posts that you create, and on that mode, you can then see them in the main hub world. I don't think it's in Cobbler's Square in Splatoon 2, but I can't remember the name of it, and I'm sorry. But the point is, it is still a Miiverse-like feature. And I got the theory that maybe because Nintendo looked at Miiverse and they realized, oh, well, this particular game has Miiverse, but nobody's really using it. But on this game, they're using it quite a lot. So to save server space, let's only use it on games that have a history of Miiverse being used a lot. Admittedly, I'm no expert on this sort of thing. It might not actually make a difference whether they support it on all games or they only support it on certain games, but to me, the more games that have Miiverse support, the more servers that are needed to host the service, and those servers cost money. So to me, why should Nintendo bother having a whole Miiverse service when only a bunch of games are even being used on it? So to me, are they just going to get rid of Miiverse entirely and have a Miiverse-inspired mode in the games itself, similar to what Splatoon 2 does? Of course, this is entirely a theory, and I'm not saying they will do that, but that's my speculation on what they could be planning to do as a substitute for Miiverse. So, that's really all I can say about it. So, this is where you guys come in. Do you care that Miiverse is gone, or are you one of the people that is bummed out that it's gone? So, sound off in the comments down below if you wish to, and I will see you guys next time. This is Nintendo's Commander. I thank you for watching. Bye bye.